What is going on, guys? Welcome to GregglesTV Daily, your source for daily tech news. Make sure you subscribe so you know what's going on in the world of tech. First story of the day is about the OnePlus 5. Now, OnePlus 5, we've seen part of the front of the phone, and now we're seeing the back of the phone. This is an official photo tweeted out by OnePlus. Now, the tweet says a continuous hard edge refined over 3 years, and it's the back of the phone, and you can see it confirms the dual lens camera. It's horizontal, not vertical, and it's horizontal just like the iPhone 7 Plus. It's got the flash to the right of the lens, and this one's black. It's got the antenna lines, it looks like, above the camera, and it looks great. There's nothing wrong with this phone in terms of what we've seen so far. Is it a revolutionary design? No. But does it need to be? No. Most people keep their phones in cases. It doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter. It's also supposed to be one of the thinnest flagship phones, if not the thinnest flagship phones. Again, does it matter? Not really. I'd rather have amazing battery life over anything. But the phone looks great. There's nothing to worry about this phone at all. We have to wait till June 20th to get everything official in terms of the price and specs. But we kind of already know the specs. We kind of already know what it looks like at this point. But June 20th is the official launch date. There's a rumor, like we talked about yesterday, that it's going to be released on June 22nd to be able to be purchased that day. So I imagine that we'll know everything June 20th in terms of the release date for June 22nd. Also about the OnePlus 5, they released a video the other day showing off them recording a concert. With the OnePlus 3T versus the OnePlus 5, and when they recorded the video with the OnePlus 3T, it was like super muffled because the music's super bass, so you can't really understand what's going on with the audio. But when the OnePlus 5 comes out, birds are chirping, everything. Well, birds aren't chirping, but it sounds awesome, sounds really good. I would love to hear like a Galaxy S8 Plus recording the same thing, or an iPhone, just to see if those sound just as good, if not better, than the OnePlus 5 does. But it's very encouraging. It looks like all the things that people were partly upset about with the OnePlus 3T, hopefully it'll make up for the OnePlus 5. I think the biggest things are it having a 2K screen, obviously better video and better camera for photo taking. Wireless charging, I think, would be a big thing that people want. I don't really care about it. Water resistance would be a big thing. Again, I don't really care about it, but it'd be nice to have. So June 20th, only a few more days. And our last story of the day is sure to make some people upset, and that's for damn sure. And it's about the fingerprint sensor on the new Galaxy Note 8. There was a story released today saying that the fingerprint sensor on this phone will be on the back and not under the screen like we were all hoping it would be. A Samsonic Electronics official said, "We made every effort to install a display integrated fingerprint sensor on the Galaxy Note 8, but we decided not to install it on this strategic phone due to various technical limitations such as security. Samsung Electronics will continue to research and develop with companies such as Crucial Tech, which has the technology." Now, this kind of sucks, and it sucks because right now, if they put it on the back, especially in the same spot that they put the Galaxy S8 Plus, it kind of sucks. This fingerprint sensor is not the best, for sure. I like the oval ones like that are on the Pixel XL and a bunch of other phones. They're faster, they seem, and more accurate when they're oval rather than this kind of square one that they use on the Galaxy S8, S8 Plus. Now, it would have been great if it was under the screen and it worked really well, because then you would have one less button thing going on physically with the phone. It would be all be on that screen, and the screen's beautiful already, and to be able to unlock your phone that way would be amazing. It would be a cool little trick to show your friends. Now, the story also references that Apple's having an issue with it, and a couple weeks ago we heard that Apple iPhone would have it. The new iPhone 8 would be under the screen now. It does shock me that Apple would be at that point to release it, because like they've said in interviews, especially about this speaker thing, they don't like to be first in technology. They like to be the best. And for them to be the best, especially if something's not working for Samsung, not to do it, because Samsung will just be like, hell yeah, let's do it. And they just do it. I would doubt Apple's going to do it if it doesn't work. Apple's probably using the same people that Samsung does to do this. So will Samsung Galaxy Note 8 have it? It sounds like not. And will Apple's iPhone 8 have it? I highly doubt it. Guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. New videos every single day. Thank you to my Patreon supporters, guys. If you love what I do, Patreon is a great way to support the Greggles TV show. I will link it in the description down below. My product of the day, guys, is listed in the description down below. It is the Pitaka Galaxy S8 Plus case. They make this same case for basically every flagship phone, from iPhone to Galaxies and basically everything in between, I believe. But anyways, really cool, very slim case. Not gonna offer you killer protection, but if you're really safe with your phone, you're gonna love this case. My question of the day is, now that we think that the Galaxy Note 8 will not have the fingerprint sensor underneath the display, does that make you want the phone less? Or maybe you don't care? Let me know in the comments down below what you think. Thanks for watching. I will see you down the road. Peace. Oh, so you didn't see yesterday's news, did you? Check it out over here. Tons of really cool news stories. The video below that is my Pitaka Galaxy S8 Plus review video. Check it out. And then also, if you're not subscribed, click my head, click subscribe.